Part 4. After wiping out the beast zombies, the lizard men rounded their shoulders in fatigue and breathed sighs of relief. There was anguish on their faces, but at the same time there were faint smiles there. It was true that they had taken many casualties, but they were lucky only to have sustained that much. If the swamp spirits had not joined the fight, no, if they had come in just a little later, their formation would have collapsed and it would have turned into a rout. "We're moving out," shouted the head warriors. It was an announcement that they were heading into battle. Their bodies were weak from fatigue, and just raising their weapons consumed a great deal of effort, to say nothing of actually wielding them. They were bone-tired, but the battle was not yet over. They had to beware the enemy's reinforcements even as they eliminated the distant zombies. "All right, get the heavily wounded back to the village, the rest of you form up on us." The sound of roaring fire interrupted him. Searing heat engulfed the surroundings, and the swamp spirits at the center of the blaze wavered. As the flames vanished like they had never been there in the first place, the two spirits were in terrible shape. A single gout of fire had half destroyed them. Before the lizard men could cry out in surprise, the fires raged once more. The spirits could not endure the attacks and disintegrated into the roaring inferno. As the swamp spirits who had demonstrated incredible power against the beast zombies disappeared without a trace, the lizard men's faces went blank, unable to keep pace with what was happening before them. What had just happened? They knew that the swamp spirits had been destroyed, but they were desperately trying to deny that reality. That was because if the swamp spirits really had been destroyed, it meant that there was a more powerful monster headed their way. The lizard men looked around in confusion and also to hide their fear. Just as they spotted an undead being in the distance, a fireball once more flew from its hand. The head-sized ball of flame soared through the air in a straight line and flew into the leader squad of the lizardman troops. Under normal circumstances, flames would vanish upon contact with water. However, this fireball was a magical phenomenon and defied that logic. When the fireball touched the water, it was as though it had struck a hard surface. A roaring cyclone of flame blossomed from the point of impact. The fiery explosion consumed several lizard men and then faded away. Was this an illusion? That thought vanished in an instant. The smell of charred meat wafting in the air and the bodies of lizard men slumped on the ground was real enough. The undead creature advanced with unhurried steps, so elegant that one might take it for arrogance. That was the stride of a mighty being, fully confident in its power. As the lizard men hesitated about whether they should rush it with an all-out attack, just like how they had destroyed the skeleton archers, another fireball flew at them. The fireball exploded violently, claiming the lives of all the lizard men around it in an instant. This was overwhelming power. It made people think that everything which had happened just now was little more than a game. "You!" The lizard men shouted to clear the fear from their hearts. Just as several lizard men charged recklessly ahead, a cold, clear voice spoke from what seemed like an unthinkably great distance. "Utter foolishness." That was all their foe said. The onrushing lizard men were incinerated by a ball of flame before they could scream. The undead being took a step forward, and over 100 lizard men immediately took one step back. The disparity between their powers was like a high wall which forced the lizard men to retreat. "Run away!" A strident, electrifying cry filled the air. The voice belonged to one of the head warriors. "That one's different from the ones before him. We can't take him." That much was true. The majestic sight of the Elder Lich slowly advancing by itself was awesome one. It made the lizard men feel as though a mighty wind was blowing across their skin. "Go inform the chiefs and Zayusu about this. We'll try to buy time." Another fireball exploded, and several more lizard men lay upon the ground. Run. Go tell them. The five-head warriors ordered the lizard men to flee, and at the same time they judged the distance between them. They were spacing themselves out so even when a fireball burst, at least one of them would be able to close the gap to the enemy. It was a suicidal tactic designed to accomplish that objective. After spreading themselves out, the five of them looked at each other, and then sprinted. The enemy was roughly 100 meters away. They despaired at the distance separating them, but even so, they ran with all their might. That was because even if they paired halfway, their deaths would still give the chiefs and Zayusu information they could use. The lizard men who had effortlessly held off the enemy came running back like a flock of frightened birds. Zayusu calmly observed that sight. No, ever since that powerful foe appeared, he had been scrutinizing its every movement. His attention was focused on the undead being that could cast the killing fire. Its movements were completely different from the mindless foes from before. In all likelihood, that was the enemy commander. As the undead creature closed to within 100 meters of the five-head warriors, it began using fireball to execute area of effect attacks. This forced him to scatter, and it seemed intent on burning the head warriors to death during their run. Looks like it's time for us to take the field. Zayusu nodded at Zenbaru's words. Crush signaled her agreement as well. She was aware that this might well be a battle where they might all meet a glorious end. Yes, it's time for us to go. Its power is shocking. Our foe might well be the personal subordinate of that Supreme One, or the commander of this army. Even if it's not, it must surely be trump card of some sort. Indeed, nobody can control multiple undead of such a level. But how shall we make our move? It seems a bit too far away for us. Krush's question gave Zayusu a headache. They were not fighting to die, so they had to plan around that. Zayusu and Zenbaru could not attack at range, so they had to close in for a melee. The problem now lay in the 100 meters between them and the enemy. Zayusu and the others could probably take one or two fireballs with ease. But they would probably take more than just one or two such hits before reaching their opponent, and the true struggle would begin once they got to it. It was not hard to see how the enemy would repulse them if they tried a frontal assault while taking fireball attacks. That distance is pretty daunting. Yeah, you got that right. To think 100 meters could feel so far away. Zayusu and friends wondered how they could reach the enemy with no or minimal damage. How about burrowing through the ground? If we used priestly powers, it'd still be hard. If we could use invisibility, they could probably close the gap instantly by going invisible and using a fly spell. However, druids could not cast such spells. Then how about making a shield and advancing with it held before us? Making a shield would take too long. How about tearing one of the houses down and using it as a shield? Zenbaru smiled bitterly as he realized the futility of the words he had just spoken. The enemy attacked with explosive fireballs. Even if it was blocked, the searing temperatures would still scorch him from the side. There was no time now to make a full body shield which could withstand high temperatures. Ah, yes. We can still do that. What is it, Zayusu? Krush asked nervously, feeling a little afraid. Is my face so scary? Zayusu wondered. Still, it could not be helped. After all, he was so stressed out that he wanted to scream. A shield, you say? I think I just found one. Igva nodded, pleased with himself and the present situation. Things were going very well. The blood meat hulks were still fighting, but he had successfully advanced to the village. Several stupid lizard men had tried to attack him, but after seeing the power of his fireballs, they realized that resistance was futile. The most successful attackers were the five who had split up to rush him, but even they had only managed to get within 50 meters of him. Igva walked on in silence, like he was strolling through an empty wasteland. While he pitied the weak lizard men, albeit in a mocking fashion, it would not do to be careless. He was close to the village, his objective. Once there, he intended to continuously launch fireballs to destroy the lizard men with their village. However, the lizard men would probably try to stop him from reaching his destination. That would mean it was about time for the next counterattack. Igva looked to the village, and his suspicions were vindicated. Oh, I see. Igva saw a hydra coming at him. If that was their ace in the hole, then the lizard men would lose the will to fight once he crushed it with overwhelming force. If that happened, he would be able to destroy the village more easily. For safety's sake, Igva looked around, then checked the sky, and halted only after verifying that there were no traces of the enemy. He leisurely waited for the hydra to enter his attack range. As the hydra reached the edge of said range, it began to sprint. As expected, it was heading straight for Igva. How foolish! Did you think you could crawl all the way to me with that slothful speed of yours? Well, beasts will be beasts. With a mocking smile on his face, Igva conjured a fireball in his hand and launched it at the hydra. It flew in a straight line and struck the hydra dead center. The searing fires which emerged consumed the hydra. However, the hydra continued forward, albeit a little shaky on its feet. It continued running, though it was wreathed in flames. No, the flames had gone out in an instant, so Igva must have been seeing things. That said, the sight before him spoke of the Hydra's extraordinary willpower. Igva frowned in displeasure. The fact that it could withstand one of his magical attacks was a blow to his pride. While it was true that the Hydra seemed to have been enchanted with a defensive spell to reduce the damage it had taken, said defensive spell was not of a high tier and could not completely nullify his magic. If I recall correctly, hydras have the ability of fast healing, but it shouldn't be able to withstand flame attacks. In any case, it's a beast, so it should be full of vitality. In that case, it makes sense that it could take a hit. That reasoning comforted Igva somewhat, but it could not douse the flames of rancor within his heart. Igva was a special monster who had been personally created by the supreme being Ainzulgan. The fact that this creature had not died in one hit was an insult to his master. With cold eyes that were the polar opposite of the anger smoldering within him, Igva studied the oncoming hydra. How displeasing. Die. He cast another fireball at the hydra, and the roaring flames engulfed its body. For a moment he even thought he could smell its flesh charring from the distance. Even if his foe had not taken a fatal wound, surely it would hesitate over whether or not to continue forward. However, why is it not stopping? Why does it persist?